Hey guys, Colin here, and this week I'm really excited to show you how to do this cool tutorial on changing the color of people's eyes inside of Photoshop. All right, I'm really excited to bring you this tutorial on changing the color of somebody's eyes. So you can use this tutorial for three different things. One, you can take somebody's eyes and you can enhance what they already have because maybe it's kind of looking a little washed out or you're not really catching the color. That's really hard to do sometimes. So I'm gonna show you how to bring out their natural color, but I'm also gonna show you how to change the color. So we're gonna look at creating blue eyes, green eyes, brown eyes, and then finally we're gonna look at this for special effects. So what if you wanna do the vampire kind of a look like on Twilight? I hate to say the name of that, but but you know how the eyes were kind of red, like they just drank the blood. Maybe Underworld's a better example. So I'm gonna show you how to create that red vampire kind of eye at the very end. So I think you can have a lot of fun with this. There's a number of techniques, so let's just dive straight in. Okay, here's a picture of my friend Callan that I shot a little while ago. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna use her as a model to look at changing the color of eyes. So we're gonna do several things. First of all, we're gonna enhance the color she already has, and then we're gonna give her different colored eyes, and then at the end, we're gonna do this special effect just for fun. So the first thing we need to do is zoom in so we can see them clearly. So if you grab the magnifying glass here and you double click it, what it'll do is it'll take you to 100% view. You can see that in the bottom there. So I just wanna hit the space bar and now I can just drag it over so I can see her eyes clearly. Now I'm going to show you two different methods. First of all, I'm going to show you a really quick basic method, and it's not quite as good as the second method, and I'll explain why in a second. But what we're going to do is create a new layer. So go to the new layer icon there and just create that new layer. And we're going to change the blend mode. The blend modes are up here. And we're going to go down to color. So we've got a new blank layer with a color blend mode. And what color does is it will change the color without changing anything else. So what we're gonna do is choose a color. We grab our brush first. I just hit the B key, by the way, to create a brush or to choose the brush. Then we're gonna grab the color swatch there and we're gonna go for a green color. So I've chosen a green color, click okay. Notice our color there is green. And so then if you grab the brush and you paint, notice what it does. I went a little bit over, so let's try that again. A little bit, not quite so crazy. There we go. And if you look at that, notice that we're able to quickly apply that color. Now, it doesn't look very believable, but if we drop the opacity down a little bit, it'll start to look a little bit more natural. There we go. All right, so that's not bad, but now I'm gonna show you a better way. So I'm just gonna delete that by hitting the delete key. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna use curves. Now, why do we wanna use curves? Well, it's gonna create a more high-end look. Because when we change the color, what it did is it just changed the overall color. But if you look at somebody's eyes closely, you'll see there's little specks that are different colors. Usually people have more than one color in their eyes. So this second technique is actually going to keep that the colored specks in there, and it's going to make it look a lot more natural. So what we're going to do is create a curves adjustment layer. So we're going to go down to the adjustment layers, and we're going to grab curves. Now, I'm not gonna get into all the ins and outs of how curves work right now, because I have another tutorial that shows you that, and I'll add a link to that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna look at curves specifically for changing the color of the eyes. Now, here's one of the things. If I adjust this curve right now, notice it's gonna affect the whole image. Well, we don't wanna do that. We only wanna affect the eyes only. So let's have a look at how we're gonna do that. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go into curves, and we're gonna double click there on that mask, and we're gonna choose invert. And then what it does is it hides the effects of that adjustment layer right now. You could also hit Control I or Command I on Windows to get the same result. So that means now this adjustment's not gonna do anything. But we do want it to do something, but just on the eyes. So the way to do that is to paint with white, because in the mask, when it's black, what it does is it hides the contents of that layer, and where it's white, it shows the contents of that layer. So we want to grab white as our foreground color. So I'm just going to hit the X key there to switch them around. And now we've got white as the foreground color. And so what I'm going to do, make sure that our opacity is turned up to 100. I'm going to paint in here around the eyes there. And what I'm going to do is just paint in here to select that area. So that means that just this area, notice it's looking dark, and that's because I turned it down in the curves earlier on. So we can kind of see that it looks dark. So we're gonna just double click now on this little icon, and it's going to bring up our properties again. So if we want to reset it, we're just going to hit that little reset button. And notice now everything looks normal again. But when we adjust this, notice it's only going to adjust the eyes, which is exactly what we want. All right, so the first thing we're going to do now is we're going to give her sapphire blue eyes. So let's go under the different channels here. See where it says RGB? That's red, green, and blue. That's our composite colors. But if we click on there, we see we can go to the individual color channel. So we're going to grab the blue color channel. And then we're just going to go in the middle there, and we're just going to drag that up a little bit. Notice as we do that, we see a lot more blue in her eyes. All right, so that's just the color. But let's have a look under there and go to the RGB area. And now what we could do is we could brighten them up a little bit to make them a brighter blue, or we could pull it down to make it a deeper, darker blue. So see how you can change that there. And notice what it does too is it retains those little specks in the middle there and it gives it a variety of color, which makes it look more believable. All right, so let's go and reset this. So now what we want to do is we want to give it green eyes. So as you can imagine, if we go under the green channel, this is where green lives. So we're just going to click and drag up to add some green color to her eyes. So there we go. That's pretty excessive. But let's go here and go to the RGB once again. We can brighten this up a little bit, or we can drop it down. Now, don't forget, you can also adjust the opacity of that layer. So if you want to make it more subtle, you can do that. So there we go. We got a much more believable kind of a green there. Then we push it here. Maybe it's a little much, but maybe that's the effect you're going for. All right, so let's have a look now at creating brown. So we're just going to double click. We're going to reset this. All right, so let's go to the RGB and go to the brown. Oh, there is no brown. All right, you kind of knew that was happening. So what do we do to add brown? There's no brown. Well, what we're going to do is use the other color channel. So we're going to start with red. And we know that the color brown has a bit of red in it. So what we're going to do is we're going to increase the red a little bit to about there. Now we're going to go to the blue channel, and we're going to pull back on the blue channel a little bit. There we go. Now we're starting to get a brownish color. I feel like just a little bit of green will probably complete this effect. So let's go to the green, and then we're going to pull up a little bit of green or pull it down. Just play around. All right. That's not bad. Let me go here. Okay, so there's one thing missing, and that's that the brown eyes are generally darker than her natural color here. So what we need to do is darken it. So we're going to go up to the top here. It says RGB. And now we're going to pull it down and create some nice, deep, dark brown eyes. So there we go. So we're able to do that. And if we zoom out, you know, a little bit, we can probably see that a lot better. So see how that looks a lot more natural. And once again, you can reduce the opacity if you feel like it's too much. So the great thing about this is it's completely non-destructive, so you can go in there and you can tweak those eyes as much as you want. So let's zoom back in to 100%, grab my space bar and move this over. So let's look at the final one. We're going to double click here and we're going to reset this just to let you know you can do pretty much anything you want with this. And you can create special effects. You can do fairy eyes or demon eyes or whatever you want. But in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to create vampire eyes. So we want to create those red. So we're going to go to the red color here. And we're going to push the reds up quite high. There we go. It's kind of glowing right now, but we're going to do a little bit more here. Let's go to the RGB, and we can maybe darken it down. So I've kind of got a little bit violet crimson eyes. So let's have a look here at the blue or the green. Actually, let's go to the green. And we're just going to play around. Let's take the green down and go to the blue. And notice as we just kind of tweak these different color channels, we can tweak the colors exactly how we want. So here we go. We've got a bit more of a kind of a blood red kind of effect. And if we zoom out a little bit, you can kind of see that. So there's the vampires just drank some blood. All right, so that was quick and easy. So drop a like if you like this. Do me a favor, if you're not a subscriber, hit that subscribe button right now. I would love you to become a subscriber. I'd be honored, in fact, if you subscribe. And then that way, when I put out new tutorials every week, we're going to make sure that you can get your hands on them and you can watch these tutorials and become better at Photoshop and Lightroom and the occasional drone video. So anyway, add a comment in the comments section. Let's get a discussion going. Let me know what you'd like to learn next time. And until then, I'll see you at the cafe.